Michael. Any news of Jason?
Nothing yet.
Look, maybe you should go home. I'll arrange for a car and have him call you if anything changes.
No. I prefer to wait here.
Jason's gonna be okay.
You know, years ago, we waited for Jason. Prayed that he would wake up. And we didn't realize that when he did wake up, he was going to be a stranger.
And you think it could work in reverse? That he could wake up from this and be the person he used to be?
It would be nice to think that we could have our own Jason back.
Mm-hmm. Or be kind of hard on everyone who loves Jason the way he is now.
An even darker thought would be for him to wake up and be a stranger to us all.
No, we can't think that way.
Say, your name came up last week in the board meeting.
Hmm? Oh, let's talk about something other than work.
And you know, I'm not alone in feeling that you have a really great future at ELQ. Hmm?
Look, I'm really grateful for the opportunity that you gave me.
But.
Look, I can't tell you what it means to me and Abby that you gave us this chance. And I hope that she will be judged on her own merits after...
After you're gone. Huh? Oh, God, I've lost you too. So what are you going to do for work now, huh? Has Sonny offered you a position in his criminal organization?
Okay, look, I know that you're disappointed.
I am terrified for you. If you don't get out of the hands of that gangster...
That's my father. Look, I don't want to upset you anymore, so let's just forget about it.
Look, we only get so many chances. This may be your last chance.
What, to be a Quartermain? Like AJ, my biological father, who's drinking is the reason you're sitting here again waiting for Jason to get out of surgery.
I've already lost Jason once. I don't want to lose you.
You keep talking about losing me. I've never been a part of your family.
Whose fault was that?
It's nobody's fault. It's just... It's how it worked out. I mean, look... Like when Jason came out of his first accident, he lost his memory. But you didn't lose him. You just lost all the ideas of who you wanted him to be. Like, if Jason comes out of this Jason Quartermain, will you love him then? Because all I'm hearing is everything is conditional. Dr. Trent, call 7. You don't love Jason the way he is now. Dr. Philip Trent, call
7862. Did you wake it?
No.
Okay, you know what? This is taking way too long. I'm gonna go look for a doctor, right?
Yeah, what's going on?
Nothing.
Then I can see something's going on.
No, I don't want to drag you into this.
Dad, whatever it is, I'm on your side. I want to help. I know the pressure that you're under, Dad. And Jason's in surgery. Everybody's turned against you after what happened with Jax.
I don't want to put you in a position where you're going to have to choose sides.
Dad, I'm on your side. Always.
Paging Dr. Garrett. Dr. Henry Garrett.
All right, you're going to hear about this anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and tell you. Your mother... took Morgan away from me.
What?
She sent him off to military school so he would be safe away from me.
She said that?
She said that, yeah. I can only see Morgan when your mom arranges it, and then when I do see him, there's got to be a guard there. She had her reasons for choosing this place. I mean, Jax actually chose the place.
Jax? What do you mean?
Well, Jax, you know, he picked the military school because he felt like my money and power wouldn't influence me seeing Morgan. So one more thing. Your mom changed his name.
This is unbelievable that she would do this to you. Me and Morgan.
His name is Morgan Benson. Okay. And she said that it's better for him to have that name, and there's nothing I can do about it. She seemed pretty confident about that.
Dad, you still got me, okay? You still got me. I'll do anything to help you.
Dr. Frankfurt, Chief of Work.
This is my dad, okay? And there are limits, because I don't want to lose another child.